In this screencast, I'll give you an introduction to another form of convective heat transfer, in other words, impinging jets. And a jet or an array of jets that strikes the surface actually enhances coefficients for convective heat transfer. So we're still going to use Newton's law of cooling, which says the Q is equal to H times A times some delta T, where the heat transfer coefficient H is obtained from correlations from the Nozzle number. However, with impinging jets, there are complex geometric considerations to take into account. So the secret to solving these is to determine the appropriate geometric features and then choose the correct correlation. So let's start with a diagram of an impinging jet. Here we're going to start with the nozzle right here. And the width of that nozzle, depending on whether it's a slot or a round nozzle, is known as D or W. At the nozzle exit, we have a velocity and a temperature, so we call that velocity at the exit and temperature at the exit, and these will be used in the Reynolds number as well as in Newton's law of cooling. Other important values are this H that I've put here, which is the height from the nozzle exit to the surface, and this area of the what we call cell impingement, so where the jet is actually hitting. And here we're going to call it R. It can also be X depending on whether it's circular or rectangular. So that R or that X is used to find the cross-sectional area of that cell. We also define something known as a hydraulic diameter. And what that is 4 times the cross-sectional area divided by the wetted perimeter. And so this is for the nozzle exit. For a round nozzle, actually the hydraulic diameter is the same as the diameter. However, if it's a slot nozzle, then our hydraulic diameter is 2 times W. And this hydraulic diameter we use not only in calculating the Reynolds number, but also in calculating H from our Nusselt number correlation. A final important geometric parameter is what's known as the relative nozzle area, and that's the cross-sectional area of the exit divided by the cross-sectional area of the cell that's being impinged upon. So we have 4 different correlations that we're going to look at. One for a round nozzle, one for an array of round nozzles, one for a slot nozzle, and finally for an array of slot nozzles. So let's take a look at a round nozzle correlation. As you can see, this Nusselt number is a function of that relative nozzle area, the ratio of that height divided by that diameter, as well as the Reynolds number. This correlation is used solely for one round nozzle. So the second correlation we'll look at is if we have an array of round nozzles. For an array, note that we've introduced another important geometric feature, which is known as S, or the pitch. And the pitch is the distance between the center of 2 round nozzles. So for example, the pitch is just the distance between those 2 points. And so now our relative nozzle area includes that parameter or the pitch. The third one that we'll look at is what's known as a slot nozzle. As you can see here, this is very similar to a round nozzle. However, instead of using D, we use this W, and instead of using R, the radius of the cell, we use X, which would be the length. We finally have a correlation for an array of slot nozzles. Again, for our array, we have a pitch. However, this pitch is defined a little bit differently, such that when you have these plates where the slots in between, the pitch is from this edge to this edge. So these look like very complicated correlations, but the secret to doing it is as follows. The first thing you want to know is, what kind of impinging jet is it? Is it round? Is it a slot? Is it an array? And that will allow you to pick the correct correlation. The next thing you have to do is calculate the appropriate geometric parameters. So that's things like the hydraulic diameter, the velocity of the exit, which is usually given to you, W or D, the temperature at the exit, the pitch, the relative nozzle area, and that H, the distance between the surface and the nozzle exit. Some of these are going to be used in your correlation. Many of them will be given, but you need to know which ones you need to use and either calculate them or look them up. Then you determine the appropriate temperature to look up the fluid properties. And for these correlations, you use the film temperature, which is the temperature of the surface plus the temperature of the air or gas exiting the nozzle divided by 2. And remember, this film temperature is in Kelvin. So then the next thing you want to do, if you notice, all the correlations require the Reynolds number. So if you notice, you have to use the velocity at the exit. You have to use the hydraulic diameter and then divide it by the appropriate kinematic viscosity. Now, let's find the correct correlation. And one of the things to do to make this a lot easier is to solve it in parts. And if you notice, for all four of these correlations, they have different pieces to it. So for example, we can go all the way back to the first one, and here we have a G. And by the way, the way this is written, this G is a function of A sub R and H over D, and then they define the function, what the function actually is. So here you'd calculate your A sub R, then you'd calculate your G, and then finally you'd calculate this term and multiply it by G, and then you're going to take this Prandtl to the 0.42 to the other side, and then you have your Nusselt number. Here, for this one, the same thing, and again, this is K is a function of A sub R and H over D, as is G. So you calculate your G, you calculate your K, you multiply them together times 0.5 times that Reynolds to the 2/3, again times the Prandtl to the 0.42. So if you look at every single one of these, can be solved in parts and then calculate your final Nusselt number. After you have the Nusselt number, remembering that the Nusselt number is equal to H times the diameter, which is the hydraulic diameter, divided by the thermal conductivity of the fluid. You solve for your H, and you have to be careful here again that you use your hydraulic diameter. And then finally, you can solve for that heat transfer such that Q is equal to that H times the cross-sectional area of the cell, because that's where the heat transfer is from, times our delta T, which in this case is T of the surface, minus our exit temperature at the nozzle. So in a subsequent screencast, I'll solve some problems using these correlations.